Hi, I'm Xisis, and we're playing the German Empire in the Great War Redux mod for Hearts of Iron 4. And today we gotta defend the Balkans. Now let's put it on play here. And we can see where we start off. So we've got some troops poised to take Cetinje. And the Persian government has declared war on the Russian Empire. This means that they should be joining our side in this conflict. Persia, of course, is down here in what is to be Iran. Actually, it looks like we've got two Persias. I think we want to just pop up the factions map mode. Yeah, okay, so I should be joining up soon. Let's see what happens. Yeah, interesting. Oh well, we are still building up our forces a little bit down here. We have 10 divisions unassigned here. This is perfect. I think we might want to... Where do we have this army? This is the... They're on the Italian border. And these are our marines down here. And then we've got our motorized that are currently going a little bit everywhere. I think we might want to actually redraw this line and keep our motorized divisions on this side. I think if we can manage to pincer them off here, that's going to be a good thing for us. I think our marines can really just attack there from with everyone from all directions. These 10 divisions, I think we'll just pop directly up here. No, what happened there? Why did they get spread out into all of these armies? Let's put them all into this one. This one I want. And then we can maybe start moving our garrison divisions back as we deploy more troops here. Yeah, these are going to be deployed soon enough. I probably want to have even more of them. But this will be a full replacement for this army, so we'll start with that. Don't think we are in the position to push anything here on the Western Front at the moment. We've been trying to take this tile for quite some time, but I think they've got a level 4 fort here, so it's really hard to break through without any armor. And this tile we should take. And we're not doing the attacking up here, of course. Because Greece kind of ended up in a bit of a pickle in the end of the last episode. That was what we were going to use these 10 divisions for. I guess we still can. You go into there and select you all. And let's pop them down here. And see what we can make with them there. As these are holding on fine here, there's a little bit on the power, but they're very, very, very low strength of these Italians. And it looks like we are taking this on here. And that's the last division deployed. Let's get them down on the border here too. Should the 1916 Olympics be cancelled? Pierre de Coubertin expressed his feelings concerning the 1916 Berlin Games in a letter to the Associated Press, echoing the sentiments of many that the 1916 Olympic Games may be an impractical, impossible event. Though many US cities have offered to host the Games instead, the International Olympic Committee must abide by its own rules and keep the site in Berlin. Perhaps there will simply be no games this year. The committee wins gold in poor foresight. And there we go. Okay, so maybe we have... what happened here? I kind of want them all to stay here. No, that was the wrong one. You go there. and redeploy quickly. I shouldn't be moving so much back and forth here. Okay, so we finished researching the railway guns. Let's see what we want to pick up instead there. I want to put a few of them into production too, I think. It's actually only 1 year ahead of time. Now we'll hold on a little bit on those. The Albatross. Yeah, we're going to pick up the Albatross here. And let's see where we can find our railway guns. So I think we put 5 factories on this. Put them up at the top of the queue. How many do we want? We want quite a few of them, don't we? Probably want to have one assigned to each of these armies. I want to get 8 of them out then. And we can fill up with the factories we are constructing, I think. Yeah, that's gonna be fine. Oh, I think we're doing fine on our conscription laws and things. Maybe we can get something done down here, though. As for airships, we're not really doing anything with them at the moment. We could, I guess, go down some of these here. Befriend Holland. And we have... we do have these naval ones as well to do. I don't think anything here is going to help us too much. No, let's just keep it on naval production for now. Alright, so let's see if we can get all our motorized divisions in place here. Let's see if we can, we'll just wait for them to gain back a little bit of organization. And let's join in to this fight here. And we'll try to throw these Landwehr Infanteriegruppe out. Yeah, this shouldn't be that hard to break through. And Montenegro has capitulated. As long as they keep pinning on this side and this side, we should be able to take this tide easily, and then we should be able to roll up this Belgrade pocket here. Okay, so our marines are done down here. You should probably be strat redeploying. It looks like this pocket is falling out there. Don't need the marines down here. They can probably be of good use up here in northern Italy in a little bit. They have a quite offensive setup in their templates, of course. They've got lots of artillery and mortars and things. We could use them up here too, actually, to help open up the fronts from where we've got naval crossings. Let's move them up here. And we can open up a second front on the places we need there. Yes, we will sign a non-aggression pact with Persia. Or with one of the Persias, the southern Persians. We're not going to go to war against them, I don't think. It would be nice to... Actually, we've got a good collection of troops here. It would be so nice if we could encircle Dunkirk. That's one. Yeah, that's gonna be a tough one. Let's keep going that way. And they've got their railway gun here too. We don't have air support either. I don't think we've got enough airports in range either to boost this up. They got so many fighters. I've got an airport here. We could put up some more Do we have enough? Yes, we've got enough for another fighter wing. Air superiority. I think daytime only. And we... no, we don't have that airport. Now we can't really be closer to the front or further from the front than this. Do we have any airports available in the Balkans? I don't think so. We've only got the one here in Belgrade. And nothing for northern Italy either. Yeah, we do have one airport there. How are we doing for aircrafts? What do we have? One. Okay. Yeah, we're not going to do anything with that. Maybe we could move some aircraft from... I don't think we want to keep those there, though. Yeah, we'll leave this be for now. I think we are currently facing these rifles out. We just got such a good production efficiency here, we don't really want to lose that to put it all into the newer ones just yet. And some more chromium. Let's get rid of that deficit while we can. Okay, so what's happening down here? Well, let's move in there and push a bit. It looks like we should be able to push them out from there too. And maybe even there. Can attack from quite a lot of the different directions. That would be nice if we can take Thessaloniki. The supply down here is not very good. It is, of course, everything goes through Belgrade. So that's kind of the key point we need to take. Guess we could hook them up here, but we've got some way to get supply down here. We've got 20 at least. How are we doing up here in France? France is doing good now. Probably can move forward a little bit more here into Poland. I think we add another vector there that'll give a good encirclement on Warsaw. Should be able to push forward a little bit here, I think. Yeah, that looks good. Up here we've got the river, of course, that we need to ford to be able to get anywhere. Yes, you may resupply. This is looking good. Let's support this attack from that direction too. And then we've got... Okay, so we're not getting that breakthrough quite there. We can only go with these divisions. Let's cross the river into this tile. Mostly to keep them occupied so they don't reinforce this battle. I might be able to cross the river and take it too, of course. It's just a bonus. Okay. The Italians are out here fighting the Austro-Hungarians. Looks like Thessaloniki will be falling soon. And most here of northern Greece should be falling too. It looks like Bulgaria is getting the occupation of everything here. Let's join in from that victor. That looks good. Can we do anything up here in Italy? Don't think so. These divisions are garbage for attacking. They're hardly good enough to defend with. Well, this looks like we did well. Let's see if we can't... No, maybe not. Let's get two of them moving forward here. This one is so weak we should be able to push. I think actually the same thing here. Let's put one division into either one of those tiles. And it looks like Warsaw should be up for grabs now too. Thessaloniki is very soon in our hands. Just need to clear out the last few Greek troops here. There we go. Very nice. You can stick around there, I think. And then we want to close out this pocket up here too. And we have created a Belgrade pocket. That's very nice to see. Now we just need to roll it up too. And they won't be able to reinforce here at least, so we just need to knock them down. Soon Warsaw will fall as well. I wonder how far we need to push the Russians before they start to falter. And of course this isn't this is occupied states. Here we go. The course start already in Brest-Litovsk, in Belarus and Ukraine, I guess. Should also be, no, that's also an occupied state. Yeah, and they got, yeah, that's so they, as soon as we get in there, here we go. The fall of Warsaw. The Russian Empire retreated from Poland under the pressure of the German Empire. Despite the strong resistance from the Russian side and the heavy fighting, the German army has managed to cross the Vistula River. Warsaw, under heavy bombardment and gunfire, finally surrendered to the ever-approaching German army. The Russians have employed scorched earth tactics to keep the Germans from supplying in local villages. The people of Russia find themselves questioning whether or not the Tsar could lead the country to victory, with such a large city falling to the enemy forces. This defeat has provoked a series of anti-German pogroms in the Russian cities and a huge wave of deportations of Jews from the Pale of Settlement, as the Russian command feared that the Germans would try to use these lands to agitate people who were dissatisfied with Tsarist Russian rule. Another defeat of the Russian army. So we are making steady progress, at least on the Eastern Front. And let's see how we're doing up here. Might actually be able to break through here. Let's pin these down a little bit there. Let's throw some more bodies into the fray. And this of course is where the airfield is located as well. That's going to be helpful if we manage to take us this tile as well. Of course, both taking it and holding it is a little bit tougher. Would like to make a assault here too. Let's see if we can't kick them out because they are so weak down here. And we want to check out this as well. So we can select... Yeah, this one doesn't really have bomber defenses. I guess that helps our Zeppelins out a little bit. That should make us lose a little bit less of them. Now we do need to do something about the fuel though. Now let's see if we can't import some more. Would like to get it from the Austro-Hungarians, but I think they lost their oil and we haven't managed to recapture it yet. Oh, here we go. This is such a nice pocket. We do need to leave someone behind, unfortunately. Let's throw a little bit more weight behind this one. They are encircled now. And don't get the encirclement penalty, of course, before we take Calais. Oh, will you look at this? We he managed to capture a railway gun as well. So, okay, you are under Ruprecht von Bayern. I want you to be assigned there as well. And you are, there we go. No, that's the wrong one. Where is, is he up here? No, that was the, of course, that's the field marshal that they are assigned under. But who, which army are they, do they belong to? Looks like they belong to the, belong to Max von Galowitz. I think he was the, he's the artillery specialist, so makes sense that he gets the first one. I think it is time to, as much as I would like to have an ambusher on them, I think we're going to go infantry expert here as well. He is one of the offensive ones, of course. And I think all of these, of course, count as infantry, infantry divisions. That max entrenchment is so nice, though. Now we're going to go infantry expert here on max. Let's see if we've got any others we can assign. Preferred tactic. Yeah, I should be able to pick one. And I think we said we were doing... Max has it. Breakthrough, yeah. Alright, so let's select breakthrough here too. And... Hermann's got the Marines. And he can select a preferred tactic. Well, maybe I think breakthrough is going to be good enough here as well. As long as we have a skill advantage, we can pull this one off. And then we have they're going to be preferred tactic for all of these characters as well. And question is, do we want these to be a little bit more defensive? We could spec them up to be, or which one's better of these ones? I think delay is probably better than backhand blow. Except that this one counters breakthrough, of course. We need to have, obviously all got skill level more than 3. And delay. Doesn't need anything. Okay, now this one means we take more damage. So we want to go for backhand blow, I think, on the defensive ones. I think we'll set these up as a defensive. And these ones as offensive. We'll just have to move our motorized armies up. Instead of having them as east and west. A little bit different from how I usually do it. Yes, we're not going to assign any roles there. And no skills to assign. We will go with a backhand blow here too. And then we have... they're set up to ambusher as well. Lutsov, let's go with a backhand blow there. And let's see what we've got here. This is our motorized divisions. Cavalry leader. Hopefully we should be able to get armored leader on this one as well. Here I think we do want a breakthrough though. And I think we will pop them up to the breakthrough army as well. Down here. Wow, these have some really good veterancy. And defending down here too. I think we abandoned the eastern portions. We're binding up a lot of British troops down here, so that's good. And the same thing here. I've actually got more of our troops on than they have. Actually, these should be gaining quite a lot too. I think we want to go with ambusher here actually. does make sense to get that extra entrenchment. I don't think we need to do a skirmisher. Skirmisher is a good mix with that, so you can make a little bit of attacks so you don't lose your entrenchment when attacking. I will... I'll go ahead. Let's have a skirmisher as well. And you are... Yeah, you're in China. Don't need to bother too much about that. This is up in... These are the ones we have guarding the ports in Germany. Yes. And we'd rather have a skirmisher. No, it's not skirmisher. Ambusher here as well. So maybe we should be... using... using him to actually command these units down here as well. That of course means we need to do something about the garrison order. But I'm thinking to grind up some experience, he can have these back. Yeah, let's do that. You get in there. We will remove this. And yes. I put them on there. These should all be decently assigned here. We'll just quickly go through and have them on garrison orders over the ports. They should all already be in on the ports. Why don't we have anyone here in Wilhelmshaven? I think that's where the port is at. Yes. And that's our most important port as well. And you are... Well, do need one down there, and we're gonna need one in... No, maybe there isn't a port in Calais. Thought there was. Dunkirk. There should be. Oh, of course, no. We got the one in Brugge. Oh, we can't see the port here in... yeah, there we go. So we're gonna need an extra one down here. Let's just assign him there for now. This should be cleaned up, no issues at all. And we have... these sitting down here on the border now instead. Maybe we can actually gain some experience for Ferdinand here. Okay, so I think we need to redraw these lines. I'd rather not have the motorized advance across the river. I don't actually mind the marines crossing the river. That is a very good way to widen the front up. And they don't have very big penalties for it. Yeah, we should be able to see here. They've actually got a 30% attack bonus across rivers. Yeah, and then the penalty is reduced from that, of course. Okay, so the stance of the Greek government on the Great War. The Entente are pressing the Greeks, which are neutral, stationing their troops in Greece. We cannot accept Greek acceptance of their presence with positive relationships with the Entente. So, of course, we demand them that they join the war. We're halfway there. We will see what they... find to do, what they find out to do with that. This isn't a good place to attack from. Not really getting anything out of this either. It would be nice if we could take the port here. It looks like they're mostly... Okay, so let's do it this way. We will grab them all around there. The three divisions we have attacking Karjali. Can keep attacking. Okay, we've got a naval invasion that's landed down here. It must come from Russia, of course. We really need to push into this province. We really need this oil. Or we want this oil on our side. I should be able to push the Russians out of here. We have taken enough points. Let's advance into here as well. Support that attack from as many directions as possible. Minimize our losses. I think we want to move our marines up here for crossing the river up on this side. Actually, they are super weak. So we should be able to cross here in any way. Let's just make a wide push across. And we'll use these divisions to push into Brest-Litovsk. And keep pushing that direction. Do you want to push over into Grodno? I think we have an opportunity here. And we will take that. Advance the front on the Russians. I think we can reassign you. And the same thing with these divisions. Don't think we need them there anymore. We were very close on the... No, we do still need them. The Romanians are enemies here, of course. We have advanced to this tile. It feels better to... Oh, maybe we can't... And it's such a small... I was thinking it should be able to. Can we just move into there? Yes. Let's help out with that. Okay, so we are in position for an attack here. We will try to take this tile next to Belgrade first. Or maybe we can start pushing just a little bit there too. Just to make sure that nothing happens. We don't really have the concentration of forces down there. We do here now though. Let's make an attack there. Yeah, when it's just not going our way, is it? No, I think that's going to be hard-pressed. We just don't have the weight behind us there. Let's pull back a little bit there. We will see if we can roll this front up a bit to... see if we can solve the supply issue, because we don't have any kind of supplies coming down here. I think everything has to go through Skopje here. If we can capture this, we might be able to bring it in from Sofia instead. Of course, it's going to help with when Belgrade falls too. And let's just lengthen that garrison order a little bit. We managed to make another small push into France here. Let's see if we can't push up just a little bit more here. Might be able to push here as well. Yeah, that looks good. Make some more probing attacks. This offensive here is going really well. And the Russians have trouble manufacturing equipment. We've got a deficit too, of course. This is going to be nice. And we've got everyone into position here. Well, as good as. Alright, so that's one province. We'll push in this way, I think. We'll just start softening them up a little bit there. And then we'll roll them back. I did manage to take Karchali, and they looks like the Turks have rolled up the British here. we're not really here yet. 81%. Yeah, we need to take the victory point here, I think. Let's keep advancing. What more do we need? It's not a lot more. It's only 3 provinces left. Let's make sure we push on them all. Let's keep advancing here. Keep the pressure up when we got it. Just pile everyone into Belgrade. Should be able to take it this time around. And now with the railway gun here. No, where did the railway gun go? Where are you? What are you doing down there? We're doing all our offensives up on the northern side. Okay, I think, yes, remove. And let's park you up here in Lille instead. Can we? No, we can't strat redeploy. Well, maybe we can push here to... Oh, they've got tank divisions here now. Let's see if we can't cross here. Let's push these tanks. No, we go this way. Keep on going that way. This is a very good offensive in France as well. Don't really have anything to do in Italy. And it looks like Greece is rolling over too now. We're better off attacking into there, I think. And getting this round. Let's slow the offensives in this mod. But we are getting there. We are getting there. Maybe we could... I can't really see. It would be nice to get some intel down here. No, we don't want to do that. Maybe we can... I think we want to have some decryption. Let's get working on some of that. See if we can't see a little bit here. Might actually have some scout aircraft we could use, but I don't think there's any airports down here. Maybe we can fly them from here. We have 2 recon planes in stockpile, alright. We fly over the Balkans, air recon. That's fine. Might help with something at least. Okay, so everyone here. Pile in there, we should be able to break them out. And here we are crossing. I think we need to send some help in, because river crossings are tough. Let's push in a little bit this way and from this direction too. There's no one there, so yeah, you stay here, I think. I think we want to go towards Reims. And push in that direction. And they are leaving their fort here. Let's take advantage of that. That might be a good place to keep our railway gun, though. And the Romanians are caving, I think. These ones here we can move out. They are no longer needed. All right. You're not really needed there either. Can you help? No. And how are we doing up here? We have the oil back in our possession. That's nice. Let's push a little bit more here. Let's grab some. See if we can't get this airport in Krakow. We're not getting into Grodno. And these are so low strength, these divisions. And then, of course, we have to deal with Britain. It's a whole other beast. There's a lot of them there. I want you to also help out here, I think. It would be nice if we could finish this attack on Belgrade off. That's almost... this is looking good. We are doing well on all fronts at the moment. Okay, so let's keep rolling this front up. We are across the Vistula, so we've got plenty of planes here we can push into. Let's put some more weight behind here. That is such a weak division, we just have to take that advantage. Let's try for Grodno again. And let's make a diversionary attack across here too. That should secure us quite a bit more. And of course we have this timer ticking against us as well. Well, we could probably... we gain some guns, it's not that bad. I was thinking maybe we do improved worker conditions just for the extra stability. We are quite low there, and our war support is ticking down quite a lot. Don't know if we can do... yeah, we can do some war propaganda. We just have so much political power. Let's do some war propaganda against the United Kingdom, I think. And that'll tank. This is a plus two stability at the end of the decision. Yeah, I think what we want to do is improve the worker conditions for a little bit. It'll cost us a little bit of production and a little bit of construction capacity, but it will bump our stability up by, it's for 180 days by 12, I think. That should bring us up to 80. I think that's a good one to do. That'll leave us in a better place at least. Let's grab some code-breaking groups as well. And now we can see what we are up against here, which is nice. That's mostly because of the decryption power, I think. We will probably need to have at least the British ciphers decrypted. Well, that will help if we, or when we need to invade them. As for the... we should be able to gain naval supremacy over them now. 4,000, maybe. Of course, they can move everything back when they need to. That would be... 110 days, I am tempted. We are got 100 days left on the tanks. We do need the turrets too. Let's grab those. Otherwise, we will have some very wonky tanks. let's make sure we are pushing into Amiens. We are on the doorsteps of Paris. This feels really good. Let's make sure we push for Reims. And we did manage to take the fort here in Verdun. Of course, I think the railway gun here helped. And here we go with another division. Now this is, that's where we want to keep them. And I think we will sign them mostly down here. I just keep pushing there. And we might have enough forces to actually break through. This is, Greece is always a pain to fight in. And these mountains here too, of course. I think we need to divert someone to help keep the reinforcements from coming in, so we don't have to waste them down completely here. And we might actually be able to take this sometime soon. And then of course these divisions here will probably just falter as the supply from Belgrade disappears. The Easter Rising. Following increasing tensions between the British government and Irish separatists, conflict has broken out as the Sinn Féin staged a coup and seized vital areas across Dublin. The Easter Rising isn't expected to succeed, but it definitely shows the Irish will to secede and is a significant embarrassment to the swollen empire. An English boss is a bastard, but an Irish one is even worse. Well, we will see what happens there. Oh, we should be able to knock out this division soon. And then all eyes will be on this division. It usually goes quite quickly once they start working on it. It's a shame we don't have any of our motorized divisions in here. It's only the marine divisions. Yeah, there we go. And just a little bit more, and Belgrade is ours. Now we can cancel off this attack for now. I think we will pull the... They can be on this side. And we can... Yeah, okay then. Let's keep them there. We will close this pocket out in the next episode, because it is time for us to end this episode. So thank you very much for watching. Take care, and see you next time.